Isn't it special to see the world from above? That's what I usually ask the new ones. The ones that aren't used to being up here yet. And also often I see in their eyes that they don't understand what I say. They think I mean it metaphorically. Especially the ones that lived as artists in their lives down there. They are hard to convince that there is no double meaning. I mean it very simply, literally, as I said it. It's special to see the world. The train slowly accelerated, leaving the old big city behind. It was shaking from side to side on the waves of the tracks as it surged its course through the incomparable lot of rails running parallel away from the old big town in the east. Those tracks, running parallel, just long enough for you to think they would continue running parallel forever, but then, with a sudden little push to the side of the wheels, suddenly decided to either cross each other or to become one forever. Crossing or becoming one. Thinking back, I decided that it wasn't the push of tracks becoming one that made me lose my balance, so I fell into your lap on that train leaving the old big town in the east, but a rough sudden push of crossing tracks. Your first impression of me must have been one of a man wanting to fly. Last night, I wrote the most beautiful piece of music. And with a smile, I went to bed, with inner happiness, expecting the moment the beautiful piece would dance into the listening people's ears. Tomorrow. But then, I heard a noise of little wings. A small, sharp noise. And flying from the dark, there came this little gray-green insect that I'm calling Doubt. And with its little gray-green wings, it sat down on my chest and looked at me and started growing. Is the rhythm of my piece fast enough? It's growing to the size of a sparrow. Did my composition really catch the mood they want? To the size of an eagle? What will they hear and feel when they hear? And what do they... To the size of a vulture? Expect from me. Expect from me. Expect from me. Will they be to the size of a monkey, disappointed by my... Misgiving, scruple, fuck you. Ambiguity, mistrust, reluctance, apprehension, perplexity. Close your eyes and listen. I'm the spirit in everybody's poem. I am with you since you've been born until you leave again. And I'll be there when you come back. And even in between when you're floating like a Kubrick baby out in space. This letter from its thin red paper, it means that now I'm sitting here in front of you, I'm looking at you silently as you read, because I could only find the right words to write and not the right ones to speak. That if I spoke, I would speak slow, with every letter drawing an image of my soul that's going to be half its size tomorrow, because I have to leave. My greatest fear comes true. I have to leave you here. Thank you.
Okay, stop. Aus.
The composer. What's wrong? Director. Das ist gut, aber falsch. Too long. Nee, es fühlt sich einfach irgendwie falsch an. In which way? Ich weiß nicht, es stört. Nee, es ist zu viel. So you want less instruments. Wenn Heiner da an die Rampe tritt und seinen Satz hat, dann höre ich ihn nicht. So he needs to speak louder. Ja, vielleicht. Du, Heiner?
Ja, was?
Kannst du mal da lauter sprechen?
Wo?
Da, wo die Musik so stört.
Okay.
Gut, dann lass uns das jetzt proben. Sorry, wait. But if the music is disturbing, then it won't be of any good if Heiner speaks up. Jetzt, Ruhe jetzt, wir proben das jetzt. Und bitte. Was ist jetzt?
Ich dachte, da kommt Musik.
Musik.
Wenn ihr uns stecht, bluten wir nicht. Wenn ihr uns kitzelt, lachen wir nicht. Wenn ihr uns vergiftet, sterben wir nicht. Und wenn ihr uns Übles tut, sollen wir nicht...
Stopp! Ich weiß, was wir brauchen.
Oh, yes.
Do you remember?
It was that night.
No, our night.
Our night?
Do you remember we bought this terrible red wine and these totally genetically engineered strawberries, and then we went down to the river and we bought cream. No, it was not spring, it was autumn. The leaves, you don't you remember? And then you took my toe between your teeth and... Our night. Don't you remember? Okay. Yeah, no, I love you. Yeah, I love you. Remember that. I love... You're gonna go. Okay. Yeah, they're waiting for me too, yeah.
Okay, bye.
If you are a creating creature that lives and makes and deals with little insects growing into elephants, you have to recognize the last impression is a big one. It's the waving of a handkerchief from a train window. And it's important if, when you'll be thinking back, you remember the colors of the flowers on the handkerchief, and if it was clean or used, if it was waved with happiness or despair, if the wind ripped it out from the hand of the one waving it from the leaving train's window, if it was carried to your feet by the wind, and if you picked it up and the flowers you saw in it embroidered reminded you of your grandmother, who kept a similar handkerchief in her white drawer next to her bed. And if this makes you remember that you love the smell of your grandmother's flat, the smell of flowers and dust and